Coming to the next example, dear students, that is ethyne molecule. When you consider ethyne molecule, it will be having hybridization in this fashion. We know that carbon has atomic number 6, it will be having 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So 1s2 electrons we cannot consider, they are closely associated with the nucleus. They cannot be easily taken away from the nucleus. It is only that 2s electrons can participate in hybridization. When you consider 2s2 electrons, one of the electrons is going to shift to the p orbital, right? Then we will be getting 4 unpaired electrons. 4 unpaired electrons, one in 2s. Here this is filled already, this is as it is. This is 2s and this is said to be 2p orbitals. Now, how does this hybridization is going to take place? We have 2 hydrogen atoms. Carbon has invited for the function for 2 hydrogen atoms. Now, it has to make accommodation for hydrogen atom to settle. This is the point. Now, very first point, if you consider sp orbital of each carbon atom overlap with sp orbital of each carbon atom overlap with s orbital of hydrogen atom, right, to form the sigma bond. Now we will see how does that happens. I'll make here that diagram, or else I'll make here. I have one carbon atom this side and the other carbon atom is present this side, right? So, sp orbital of carbon atom, they are going to combine each other, right? They will be arranging in this fashion. These are p orbitals of carbon atom. And these, can I say here, there are 3 unpaired electrons are present and 1 unpaired electron is present in 2s2. Sp orbital of carbon atom combine each other. Sp orbital of carbon atom combine each other. These 2 will form a sigma bond with s orbital of hydrogen atom. S orbital of hydrogen atom. Sp combination takes place. This is s orbital, this is p orbital. These 2 combine together, they will form sp orbital, gives place to 2 hydrogen atoms. 2 hydrogen atoms are accommodated with 2 carbon atoms, right? So I will show it in this shaded fashion, where this is hydrogen atom. Here sp sigma bond is formed. This is said to be sp sigma bond is formed. This one. Next, what they have telling, Py and Pz of each carbon atom, Py and Pz of each carbon atom overlap sideways between 2 carbon atoms. The configuration what I have written here, it is only 1 carbon atoms configuration I have written. Similarly, I have 2 carbon atoms because 2 carbon are there. Now, these Py and Pz atomic orbital of 2 carbon atoms. This is set of 1 and same set I have another carbon atom. They together will combine. See, this is said to be what? This is Py. Okay. This is also Py of another carbon atom. This is sp sigma bond. Okay, this is Py. Now I have Pz also. This is sigma, sp sigma. Now I have Pz lying in this fashion. Pz is lying in this fashion. Okay, what they are telling here, the Py and Pz of 2 atomic orbitals combine each other in sideways to form 2 carbon atoms, combine each other to form sideways overlapping. It means they are going to form the pi bond. How do they combine? See here, these are YY combination. YY combine each other, right? Similarly, Z orbitals also combine each other. Z orbitals will also combine each other. In between carbon-carbon, what bond is formed is said to be sigma bond. And above which YY combination and ZZ combination in sideways, they are sideways combining. This is axially combining. One carbon, second carbon, they are combining axially. This is sigma bond. But these two are combining like this, sideways. So this is said to be pi bond. Like this, we can see the structure of C2H2 molecule after hybridization process is done. These two are sigma bonds which are formed. Can you see this one? So what they are saying ultimately, ethyne molecule linear and bond angle is said to be 180 degree. By just seeing them, can you see here the structure would be like this? This is carbon atom. This is bonded by another carbon. This is hydrogen bond, right? We know that this is sigma bond. There are two sigma bonds are existed. I told you these two P, that is carbon atoms, also combine in this fashion, head-on overlapping. In the sense, whatever the bond we have at the middle is also said to be sigma bond. And we have YY sideways combination. In the sense, this is first pi bond. In the same way, we have ZZ combination in a sideways. Means, this is another pi bond. And as it is linear molecule, bond angle seems to be between these two, bond angle between carbon-carbon bond angle seems to be 180 degree. So like this, we can say in total, if you consider this molecule, it has got two pi bonds. The first pi bond is here and the second pi bond is here. And three sigma bonds between carbon-carbon, between two hydrogen atoms of each carbon. So, like this, we can write the hybridized molecule ethyne. So, this is said to be hybridization in ethyne molecule. The participation of atomic orbitals of two carbon atoms will combine each other. Two of the orbitals, PY, PZ, will be combining in a sideways to form the two pi bonds. And two P orbitals of two carbon atoms will be combining in a head-on overlapping. They will be combining interaxial, that is axis, internuclear axis is going to combine head-on overlapping. Sigma bond is formed. In between what we have, it is said to be sigma bond. And this is sp sigma bond with respect to hydrogen atoms. There are two hydrogen atoms are accommodated place in case of carbon atom. So this is all about sp hybridization. That is what we have here, C2, sp. There are 3 p orbitals are involved and carbon carbon is mingling, so we can consider here the hybridization is said to be sp hybridization. Hybridization is said to be sp hybridization in case of ethyne molecule. Do copy this, we'll move to next. Dear students, having done with respect to ethyne molecule, now let us discuss regarding hybridization for BCl3 molecule, boron trichloride. As boron having atomic number 5, it will have 3 unpaired electrons. Two of the filled electrons will be deeply associated with a nucleus. We cannot make use of them. See here, intermixing of 1s orbital and 1p orbital of boron will form sp2 hybridization. We will get here sp2 hybridization. Next point, sp2 hybrid orbitals arrange in trigonal planar symmetry. The symmetry and the bond angle is going to be altered here, as from that of, we have seen ethyne molecule, we have seen beryllium chloride molecule. In both the cases, we have seen the bond angle will be around 180 degree. The bond angle is going to be varied here. How does that bond angle is going to vary? Why it is so happened? We'll see with the help of orbital diagrams. Coming to the next point, I have written here the electronic configuration first. We have 5 electrons in boron. They are going to be arranged in this fashion. So 2s electron is going to shift to the 2p orbital. In the sense, 1s is involved here and 1p or 2p orbitals are involved here. So 1s is involved, 2p is involved. Totally 3 orbitals are involved here.
Now, if you consider S character and P character here, percentage if you just take away, we will be getting 33.3% of S character, one S is involved. 66.6% is P character is seen after hybridization when these atomic orbitals, that is S orbital combined with these two P orbitals, they will form hybrid orbitals. Those hybrid orbitals are referred as sp2 orbitals with three unpaired electrons. And 33% S character, 66.6 P character is observed. S of boron involved here, and P of, that is PZ orbital of boron and PY orbital of boron involved here, and they will be forming sp2 hybrid orbitals with a bond angle 120 degree. Now this boron is ready. Now boron is hybridized, and we can see this is the structure of hybridized orbital, intermixed orbital. Once the intermixing of orbitals is done, now this molecule, I mean to say this boron is ready to give space for three Cl molecules, each having one electron. This is one electron, this is one electron, this is also one electron is present here. Now each chlorine uses these half filled orbitals. Half filled p orbitals of boron to form a structure like this. One Cl will come and attach here, another Cl will come and attach here, and the third Cl will come and attach here, and they will form the bond angle 120 degree. And finally, this is said to be the structure of boron trichloride. Can you see this one? If you take the picture, it will be giving us trigonal planar observation you will be doing. So this is hybridization in case of BCl3. Coming to the next example, phosphorus pentachloride. Now it is becoming very easy for you to write the configuration and to the hybridization also. You have to practice these things in such a way that by just giving the example, you could be able to write the configuration, hybrid orbitals as well. You are supposed to guess the kind of shape or the geometry of a molecule. So phosphorus with atomic number 15 has got 5 unpaired electrons. I have written ground state, and this is said to be excited state. In the excited state, we will get one of the electron, that is 3s electron, is going to shift here d. This is somehow different from that of the previous examples we have done. Previously we have shifted electrons only to the p orbitals. Here once we have 3s2 and 3p, this is half filled, right? This is completely filled. Once we have 3s2, 3p, in the sense we will be also having 3d orbital also present. The unpaired electron is shifting to the d orbital here. This is the excited state of phosphorus atom. Now once these three are involved in the hybridization, that is p3 are involved, one d is involved and one s is involved, we can write it is said to be sp3d hybridization. It is sp3d hybridization, we can write like this. So if you consider the structure, see here, this phosphorus will get arranged with 5 orbitals, that is sp(d) orbitals are arranged, and the molecule, this phosphorus atom will be arranged with these orbitals in this fashion. Once 5 orbitals are involved, that is sp3d orbitals are involved, now 5 Cl atoms will come and combine each other. They will be combining with orbitals of phosphorus, and they will be forming the bond here. Head-on overlapping is present, and they will forming a sigma bond between the phosphorus and chlorine. And when you represent this one in this fashion, phosphorus will have got 5 electrons are combined, and the bond, see here, this is the most important thing I have to tell here. The bond angle between this P and these two Cl is different. Bond between this phosphorus and these two Cl is different, that is 180 degree, little larger than the previous all these bonds. And the bond angle between all the Cl atoms which are trigonally arranged here. This is one Cl, this is Cl, this is Cl. They are trigonally arranged. These trigonally arranged Cl carbon chlorine atoms with respect to phosphorus will have right angle triangle type of degree, that is 90 degree, but these two Cl which are above and below will be having 180 degree, that is bipyramid. This is seems to be pyramid. This is seems to be pyramid. Then if you join these in this fashion, if you join in this fashion, now this is seems to be like pyramid, the below one pyramid and the above one pyramid. We can see here these three Cl atoms are arranged, or they are bonded in a trigonal fashion. So we can say that the molecule has got trigonal pyramidal type of shape, trigonal bipyramidal, above one pyramid, below one pyramid, bipyramidal. And the hybridization is sp3d, and phosphorus Cl bond angle seems to be 180 degree, and which are above and below are there, they will be showing 180 degree, and trigonal Cl will be showing bond angle 90 degree. That is there is a slight difference in these two. Okay, coming to the next example, that is SF6, sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur with atomic number 16 has got 3s2 3p4 valence electrons. In the ground state, I have represented them 1s2 2s2. These are seems to be like 3s2 3p4 electrons are present. This is 3s2, this is 3p4 electrons. We are ignoring these electrons here because they are not going to take part in the bonding. So once this s orbital we have here, that is 3s2 orbital, what we have here is going to shift its electrons to d orbital. One of the electron is shifting from s orbital and the other electron is shifting from p orbital. Can you see here, after arrangement of the electrons in the hybrid orbital, it seems to be s, there are 3 electrons in p orbital and there are 2 electrons in d. So s sp3d2 hybridization, in the sense sp3d2 hybrid orbitals are arranging. So once the arrangement is done, next we have to see. So now orbitals are arranged in this fashion. This is seems to be sulfur, which is arranged with 6 orbitals sp3d2. So 1s, there are 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6. 6 orbitals are obtained. They are arranged in this fashion. And here, these bonding, what I am showing here is the bonding between sulfur and fluorine. This is the bonding between sulfur and fluorine. Like this, bonding takes place after the hybridization of atomic orbitals of sulfur together. S orbital, p3 orbital, d2 orbital are hybridized. Once the hybridization is done, sulfur seems to be like this. After that, 6 fluorine atoms will come and combine to 6 orbitals of sulfur. Okay, so bond angle, I'll be showing in this fashion. At the middle, we have sulfur combined with 6 fluorine atoms with a bond angle 90 degree, right? Then we also have certain other examples. Directly we will be having examples of molecule we suppose to predict the hybridization in them. So what is the type of the hybridization in the following carbon atoms, they are asking. So CH2 double bond CH, here we have C double bond OH, and here we have carbon bonded with the other carbon atom with a double bond. Whenever we see double bond is present, we can directly can say this is sp2 hybridization. Similarly, whenever we exist with a molecule 3 bonds, carbon-carbon 3 bonds are existed, we can directly say it is hybridization, that is sp hybridization.